Hey guys, welcome back. It's been a little bit since I've actually sat down and filmed with you guys, but I'm super excited for today's video because I'm doing another one for my Vegas locals or for people thinking about moving to Vegas. And that is things that you should know before you move here. And a lot of these might be obvious, they might not be for you guys. Also, a lot of these are just things that are important in my opinion or might be things that bother me about living here. So not all of them might be applicable to you, but I just wanted to kind of throw out a list to you guys if you are thinking about moving to Vegas so you have an idea going into it. So let's just jump right on in. So one of the first things that you should know if you're thinking about moving to Vegas, and this one's probably super obvious, but it's that it is super hot here. The summers are 110, 115, very, very hot days are like 120 degrees, and the summers are pretty long. They start in, honestly, yesterday was Easter and it was 90 degrees. So they start getting hot in like April, and then it doesn't cool off until usually October, November-ish. So if the heat is something that bothers you, Vegas might not be the place for you. But on the flip side, I know a lot of people who move here that are just over the snow or over the cold, and they love the heat and they love the desert weather. So if that's you, moving to Vegas will be great for you. And honestly, it's not super bad. I mean, everyone is well equipped for it. Everywhere has great AC and you can kind of just hop from one air-conditioned building to the next. So it's not like you're gonna be dying in the heat all summer, especially if you have a pool or if your community has a pool, but just something to keep in mind. Another thing, and I think I've actually touched on this on one of my other videos on Vegas, but it's that places are pretty much open like 24/7. Bars and restaurants don't really have a closing time or a last call. I don't think there's any places that aren't open on Sundays or on the weekends. Basically, everything is open all the time, which may not seem like a huge thing, but it is kind of nice if you're like hungry late at night or if you just need to run an errand at a weird time. You really don't ever have to worry about things being closed. So if you're from somewhere else, that's probably not how it is. And so in those cases, it's just kind of a nice little Vegas thing that's super convenient for you. Another thing about moving to Vegas that you might not be aware of is that there are tons of bars and restaurants off the strip, even like locals casinos that are off the strip. So you definitely don't always have to go to the strip if you want to go out to eat or go to a bar or go gambling or whatever it may be. I have another video on like different areas of Vegas, and I think I kind of touch on like some of the locals casinos and bars and restaurants that are in those areas. But yeah, you definitely don't have to go to the strip to do those things. Honestly, my family and I go to the strip maybe like a few times a year when we have people visiting, and other than that, we just have our normal local spots that we like to go to, and it's just like another, well, not exactly another city, but yeah, you definitely don't have to go to the strip for all those things. Another thing that kind of tends to surprise people, especially if they've never been to Vegas, is the fact that we have slot machines in grocery stores and in gas stations here, which is kind of a weird thing. Obviously, if you've never been to Vegas, because that's not exactly normal in most cities, but yeah, if you're getting gas or you're just doing your normal grocery run and you get the urge to play some slot machines, then you can do that. Another thing to know if you're thinking about moving here, especially from another big sports city, is that Vegas doesn't really have a huge sports culture here, but I will say that that's definitely getting bigger and better, especially from the last few years. We have the Golden Knights here, which is our hockey team that a lot of people, myself included, are huge, huge fans of. The Knights came here a few years back, and it was right around the time that the 1 October shooting happened, and it kind of just felt like the whole city really like banded around the Knights and kind of came together over that. And ever since then, there's been more of kind of like a Vegas sports culture here. We also have the Raiders coming here now, so that's obviously going to be a huge push just for more sports culture here. And then on top of that, we have a soccer team, we have baseball, we have like the UNLV basketball team. So it's definitely something that's growing here in Vegas, but I will say if you're from a city like, I don't know, like Green Bay or places like that that are really, really all about their sports, it will be a little bit different here. Another thing that you probably don't know about Vegas is that there's actually like a farm horse property kind of area. Well, actually, there's a few. But that is an area that my husband and I actually live in, and we have a decent amount of land, and we have chickens, and my sister-in-law lives next door, and they have horses, and it's just something that I think a lot of people definitely don't picture when they picture living in Vegas and seeing the Strip and that whole lifestyle. So it just goes to show that there's really no one kind of way to live in Vegas. There is a ton of different areas of town here and a lot of different lifestyles that you can live, and it just depends on what you're looking for. Another thing that I think a lot of people probably don't realize is that there are actually a ton of outdoor recreation opportunities and things to do here. There's Red Rock Canyon, which is right outside of Summerlin and is probably 20, maybe 30 minutes from the Strip. But there's some really great hiking and mountain biking and rock climbing that you can go do there. There's Mount Charleston, which is like 45 minutes from the Strip. And again, in the summer, there's some really good hiking and biking and rock climbing, whatever you want to do up there. And it's up in the mountains, so it's really nice to get out of the heat and just go be in a different environment for a little bit or for the day. There's Valley of Fire, which is like 45 minutes away, and same stuff to do there. There's Lake Mead, where you can go fishing or boating. There is really just a lot of outdoor stuff to do here that a lot of people probably don't know about, just because obviously Vegas is so focused on the Strip. But if you're an outdoorsy person and you like doing stuff like that, there is a ton of that stuff to do here. And it's just really fun to be able to go do that and have it in your backyard, basically. Also, speaking of Mount Charleston, this is another thing that people probably don't know about living in Vegas, but you can actually ski up at Mount Charleston in the winter. There's a ski resort up there. It's not the biggest, so if you're used to places like Colorado or somewhere like that, like where I'm from, it's not exactly the same, but it is pretty cool that you can go ski or snowboard or go sledding or whatever you want to do. All in like a 45 minute drive from Las Vegas. And it's just really nice to go up there in the winter and to be in the snow. And at the same time, you're only like 30 to 45 minutes from town. And in that amount of time, you can go be in the mountains and spend the day playing in the snow. Also, I know I just mentioned Lake Mead, which brings me to my next point. And that is that there is water and lakes in Vegas. Obviously, like I said, there's Lake Mead, which is like a 20 to 30 minute drive, probably depending on where you live in Vegas. But you can go boating out there, you can go fishing, you can even go swimming in it if you want to. And also on top of that, there is Lake Las Vegas, which is one of my favorite areas of town. It's just a really cool little like village out there, and it feels like you're in Europe or somewhere like that. But you can go paddle boarding or kayaking or whatever you want to do out there, and there's a lot of restaurants that you can just go and sit by the water out there. Same thing with Desert Shores, which is actually in town and is in a neighborhood, but if you live there, you can go out on the water and take your kayak or whatever out there. And again, there's also some restaurants out by the water there. So it's really nice, depending on what you want to do. You can either go play in the water or you can just go out to eat and relax and enjoy it. But yeah, there is actually water in Vegas. So if that's something that you've been thinking about or that might be a concern about moving to Vegas, there is water and there is stuff to do on it. So it's really fun to go do that, especially, like I said, in the summer to just cool off and go have a fun day at the lake. All right, the last thing that I want to talk about is just the schools here, because I know I talk to a lot of people, especially who have kids or are planning on having kids, that are concerned about the schools here. And that's because our public school system kind of gets a bad rap here. But I do want to say that Vegas has a lot of different options for schools. In the public school system, obviously some schools are better than others. And on top of that, we have a few different magnet schools around the different sides of the city, which I have heard really, really good things about. And on top of that, there's charter schools, there's private schools, there's all sorts of options for schools here. And I have a lot of friends and family that work for both the public school system and some of the private schools here. And they have a lot of great things to say about the different areas or the different schools and just kind of the options for that. So if that is something that you're concerned about, I would definitely recommend just looking into the different options a little bit more, because even though some schools here might not have the greatest reputation, there are definitely some really good options here. So just don't let that scare you away right off the bat. All right, that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed and hopefully learned something new about what it's like to live in Vegas. If you have any other questions about living here, feel free to drop them below. And if you are thinking about moving here and are interested in what that might look like for you guys, or even if you're interested in buying a house, I would love to help answer any questions that you might have. So feel free to drop any questions or comments in the comments below. And I'll also leave my social media and email in the description box below, so you can feel free to reach out to me there and I'd love to help you out. But until my next video, thank you guys so much for watching. Bye, guys.